Hello everyone, welcome to Aspiring Student. Let's discuss the important strategy for RBI Assistant Prelims 2020, my dear friends. So we all know that RBI Assistant Prelims exam is on 14th and February 2020 and 15th February 2020, my dear friends. So as the exam is very near, I would like to bring you the important strategy which helps me to crack all the prelims exams in my first attempt. Okay, so before going into the strategy, I would like to discuss with you the cutoffs of RBI Assistant Prelims in 2017 and in 2016. So this will give you a clean image of how the cutoff is going to be in 2020, my dear friends. Okay, so let's discuss the cutoff of RBI Assistants in 2017. So see friends, here are the some reasons that I have taken. Okay. So, the cutoff of 2017 in Ahmedabad region is, in general, it is 80. In OBC, it is 74. And in ST, it is 69.75. Okay. And see here, in Bengaluru, it is 77.75. And for OBC, it is 74.75. Okay, this is somewhat very near. Three difference. In Bhopal, it is 83.25. In Bhubaneswar, it is 84.50. In Chandigarh, it is 87.50. Chennai, 83.50. In Guwahati, it is 77.25. In Hyderabad, it is 87. Jaipur, 85.75. And Jammu and Kashmir, it is 80. And New Delhi, it is 85.75. And Kolkata, it is 86.50. And Mumbai, it is 74.50. So see friends, more or less, in many of the states, it is almost 80 plus. Okay, almost 80 plus. So this year, it can be again 80 plus, my dear friends. Okay, so because every year we are seeing that the cutoff is almost 80 plus. Okay, in very less states, we are seeing that in 70. Okay. If I talk about 2016, so see friends here, in 2016, in Ahmedabad region, that is 73.75. And see here, it goes to 80 here. So almost 7 increased. Okay, almost 7 increased in 1 year. And in Bengaluru, it is 71.75, my dear friends. And in Bhopal, it is 77.75. And Bhubaneswar, it is 79.75. And in Chandigarh, it is 81.50. Chennai, 78.25. And in Guwahati, it is 72.50. And in Hyderabad, it is 81.50. And Jaipur, it is 80.50. And in New Delhi, it is 81. And in Mumbai, it is 70.25. See, in 2016, the cutoff is almost 70 plus. Okay. Everywhere we are seeing almost 70 plus. But in 2017, you see here almost 80 plus cutoff we have seen in every state. Okay, so plus 10 increasing. Okay, plus 10 increasing. So every year, more than 25 lakh students come out by completing their degree. Okay, friends, that means graduation. So that's why as the students increase, as there are less number of vacancies, the cutoff will be always high, my dear friends. Okay, so I don't know how to predict the cutoff because I don't like predicting the cutoff, and whoever predict the cutoff also, because that is highly impossible, my dear friends, to predict the cutoff, because even the examiner also don't know what may be the cutoff for this year, because it depends on number of vacancies, number of students, number of aspirants attend the exam, and more or less the level of paper. Okay, so there are many factors which decides the cutoff, my dear friends, every year. Okay, so see, every time the cutoff is getting increased, but in 2018 we have not seen any recruitment from RBI assistants, and in 2019 also we have not seen any recruitment from the RBI, my dear friends. Okay, but in 2020 we have seen the vacancies, that is 926 vacancies. Okay, so 926 also a good number, my dear friends. Okay, 926 is a good number. So almost every state is having more or less 10 vacancies. Every state is having more or less 10 vacancies, leastly. And in if I talk about maximum vacancies, it has having 150 vacancies, my dear friends. Okay, maximum 150. Okay, friends. So very less it is. In some states, I have seen that there are zero vacancies. And in some states, I have seen one vacancies, two vacancies, three vacancies. So these all decides cut off sometimes. Because as it is only one vacancies, more than 1,000 aspirants will attend this paper. Then how the cutoff will be? Just assume. Sometimes we will see that 90 plus cutoff also. Sometimes we will see. Because there is only one vacancies and there are thousands aspirants are attempting this exam. Okay. So the cutoff is depends on level of paper, number of aspirants is going to attempt the exam on that day and the number of vacancies. But I am not here to tell you about the cutoff. See, here we have only 926 vacancies. Okay, so till late we have learned everything required for RBI assistant prelims to crack it. Okay, friends, and the exam dates is on 14th and 15th February 2020, my dear friends. So now what should we follow to crack this exam? So see, if I talk about the strategy of English, first, when you open your paper, first check for error detections. So we will see almost 3 to 5 questions based on error detection, my dear friends, in prelims. Okay. So after that, you check for fillers. Again, we see 3 to 5 questions based on fillers. It may be single fillers or double fillers. Okay. And next, we have sentence rearrangement. So more or less, we see again 3 to 5 questions, my dear friends. Next, word swap. We see sometimes 2 questions, sometimes 3 questions. Okay, it depends on the level of paper. And after that, you check for match the following questions. Match the following question also, we see 2 to 3 questions. And next, you check for para-jumble and idioms and phrases questions. And last, you check for reading comprehension. Okay, finally, you check for reading comprehension. So see, friends, everyone is good at the grammar. So everyone almost in 5 questions, there are 3 questions every student can attempt. Okay, so that's why here we can get 3 marks. If the exam has given the fillers, again we can get 3 marks here. Sentence rearrangement. So more or less, every student scores 5 out of 5 here. So I'm just taking a least case, that is 3. Okay, that is 3. So WhatsApp we will see in some shifts and we don't see in some shifts. Okay, and match the following also same somewhat like that. So if I just I am taking 2 marks here and here also 2 marks. And para jumble we see 5 questions. So just attempt 1 mark, that is good enough. Sometimes we will see 5 out of 5. If the para jumble is very easy, then we can get 5. If it is too tough, then we cannot. At least we can assume the what is the first statement that is to be placed. And idioms and phrases, this is also very easy, 2 questions. And in reading comprehension, we see 10 questions. You just take 6 marks here. My dear friends. So see, 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 5. How much? Sorry, this is extra case. 8 plus 1, 9. 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 2, 13. 13 plus 3, 16. 16 plus 3, 19. 19 plus 3, 22. In English, 22 is a very good score, really. Okay. In English, 22 is a very good score, my dear friends. And if you feel that I am not good at grammar, you first attempt reading comprehension. So from reading comprehension, we can easily score 6 marks, my dear friends. Okay, from reading comprehension, we can easily score 6 marks. See how almost 3 to 4 questions will be given from the passage. And next, one question is based on vocabulary. And one question is based on synonyms and antonyms. And one is based on that what we say, idioms and phrases. So sometimes you will see a blank question. Okay. So more or less, we can easily score 6 marks from reading comprehension, my dear friends. So after getting 6 marks in reading comprehension, you check either error detection, fillers, sentence rearrangement, word swap, match the following, parasymbol, or idioms and phrases. So in these topics, you can easily score. Even you are very poor in English, you can easily score with your common sense at least 10 marks. At least 10 marks. So if it is very high for you, see, even if you feel that is very high for you, you can easily score 7 to 8 marks, my dear friends. You can easily score 7 to 8 marks. But these marks will never help you to crack your prelims. Okay, these marks will never help you to crack your prelims, especially RBI assistants. Because just now I have shown you how the cutoff is going. So more or less, you have to score 20 plus marks in English, my dear friends. 20 plus marks in English. So from this, you get 6 marks. Okay, and from this rest of all the topics, you try to score at least 14 to 15 marks. At least 14 to 15 marks. Okay, that you will be in the race. If not, just lose your hopes and prepare for the next exam. Because the RBI assistant exam is very easy and the questions are very direct. Okay, so every aspirant, just by seeing the question, they can click the answer. Just by seeing the question, they can click the answer. That's why the cutoff is going very high every year. That is the reason behind this cutoff very high. Okay, friends. So they will give very easy and direct questions. So the aspirant who prepared well, just by seeing the question, he will mark the answer. So that's why every student is scoring in English 25 plus marks. And sometimes 30 out of 30 also. Okay. So this is the main reason for the cutoff, my dear friends. For the high cutoff. Okay. So English is your deciding factor. So everyone can score good marks in quant and reasoning. But only a few students score good marks in English, my dear friends. So that's why I'm telling you. Practice well. Practice more and more quizzes. So just After attempting the quiz, just recheck the quiz. Okay, so where you have did the wrong. So if you do it continuously, then you will be also able to score 25 plus marks in English, my dear friends. Okay, 25 plus marks in English. Because if I talk about SBI or IBPS, some questions are very direct and some are tricky to answer. But in RBI assistant, we don't see such a tricky questions in prelims. They will give very direct questions. Straightforward questions. Just by seeing the question, you can click your answer if you are prepared well. Okay, so this is all about English, my dear friends. Next, if I talk about quantitative aptitude, the many aspirants are very good at quant. So some they will score 35 out of 35 sometimes and 30 plus marks sometimes. So but aspirants who are attending first time they are going to give an exam. So what is the strategy that they should follow in quant? See friends, once check the paper, if you have simplifications or approximations, they will give almost 10 questions. They will give almost 10 questions, my dear friends. Okay. I'm taking the least cases. Okay. Sometimes we will see 15 questions, 12 questions sometime. But right now I'm taking the least case. First, by opening your quant paper, you just check whether there is any question based on simplification or approximations. Okay. After that, you go with number series or wrong number series. Okay. Here we see 5 questions here. And after that, you check for quadratic equations. Quadratic also we see 5 questions, my dear friends. Okay. 5 questions. And finally, you go with data interpretation. We see 5 questions sometimes and sometimes 10 questions. Okay, 5 questions sometimes and sometimes 10 questions. After that, you go with one word problems, that is topic based problems. So just pick which topic is your strength. So don't mess with the other topic which is very tough for you. Because If it is a practice paper, then you can easily write the, so just you practice the unknown topic. But this is a mains exam. Okay, so that means main exam. Okay, so deciding factor of your life. So that's why you don't practice there. You just attempt what you know. Okay, friends. So, but maintaining the accuracy is also very important. If your accuracy is good, then you will get the credits also. Okay, friends. If your accuracy is good, you will get the credits also. Okay. So after that, you go with Q1, Q2. That means quantity based questions. Q1, Q2 questions. Okay. See, once again, I will repeat. You first check for simplification and approximation questions. Okay. After attempting it, you go with number series and wrong number series. After that, quadratic equations. And after that, you just attempt data interpretation. And finally, you attempt one word problems. After completing the one word problems, if your paper is carrying Q1, Q2, that is quantity based questions, you just try to attempt these questions. If you are not good at quantity of Q1, Q2 questions, just skip it. Okay, just skip it. Because see, here you are getting 10 marks, here 5 marks, here 5, here 5 to 10, here at least 5 questions, at least 5 questions. Okay, so see, I will tell you the 5 topics also. Percentage, we will definitely see a question based on percentage, ages, profit and loss, next, SA and CA, averages, speed, time and distance. These are very easy topics. Okay, so that way, and the questions are also very easy. Okay, we can calculate everything in our brain only. Okay, there is no need of using pen and paper. Okay, but once going into the exam, just on the previous day of your exam, just once recall your calculation tricks, tables, squares, cubes, my dear friends, percentage values. Okay, this is very important. So now see, 5 marks, 5 marks, 5 marks, 5 marks, 10 marks. How much? 20, 30 marks. 30 marks is a very good score. Okay, 30 marks is a very good score. See, here 22 marks in English, 30 marks in quant. How much you get here? 52 marks here. 52 marks here. Okay, in English and quant. And next, let's discuss the strategy of reasoning. Very important and easy and most scoring topic. Okay, here we can score 35 out of 35, my dear friends. So that I have scored 35 out of 35 in SBI, IBPS, in both. Okay, and EPFO. So in all these exams, I have scored 35 out of 35 in reasoning. Okay, 35 out of 35 in reasoning. So how I scored? See, when I open the reasoning paper, first I check for, is there any question based on inequalities? Okay, and next after that, I check for syllogism questions. After that, I check for alphanumeric questions. After that, blood relation, directions, ranking, coding and decoding, miscellaneous questions. And finally, I attempt puzzle and seating arrangements. Finally, I attempt puzzle and seating arrangement, my dear friends. So see, in this, you see 2 to 3 questions. But in syllogisms, you see 5 questions. Alphanumeric also, you see 5 questions. Blood relation, 2 to 3 questions. Directions, 1 to 2 questions. Ranking, 1 question. Coding, decoding, 3 to 5 questions. Miscellaneous, 1 or 2 questions. Puzzle and seating arrangement, 15 to 25 marks. 15 to 25 marks, my dear friends. Okay, 15 to 25 marks we will see from puzzle and seating arrangement. Now see, if I take least case 15, 1, 6, so 16, so sometimes we will see this topic and sometimes we don't see this topic. Right now I am excluding it. So 16, 17, 18, 20, 25, 30, 33. Okay, so I have missed some 2 marks in somewhere. So if I get 3 questions in blood relation and 2 questions in directions, I can cover 35 questions. Okay, 35 questions. Understood or not? So how I, in this way I attempt my paper, my dear friends.
Coming to reasoning. First, I check for inequalities. After the syllogisms, alphanumeric, right? In the same way, I would like to attempt my reasoning paper. Last, I would like to attempt puzzle and seating arrangement. Okay. So, this strategy makes me to score 35 out of 35 many times in reasoning, my dear friends. 35 out of 35 many times in reasoning. Okay, friends. So, you can follow me on Unacademy platform also, where I am teaching reasoning, quant, okay, freely. So, I will give the link in the description box, my dear friends, okay, to my Unacademy profile also. There you can follow me for quant and reasoning topics. So, that many aspirants also, many of my students scored 35 out of 35 in reasoning. Because I am sure that my classes will definitely will help you to score 35 out of 35 in reasoning, especially in prelims. Because I have almost covered all the topics which is very important for your prelims to score 35 out of 35. Okay, even I have discussed some important techniques also to score 35 out of 35, my dear friends. Okay, all this makes my students to score 35 out of 35 many times. Okay, so this is the strategy that is required to follow for your RBI ASSISTANT prelims. Okay, friends. So this is for English, this is for quant, and this is for reasoning. So, okay, I wish you a very good luck for your exam. So, on the day of exam, I will bring you the memory based questions. Okay, friends. So, subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon. If you like this video, please hit the like button and do comment what you're feeling, your feelings on this video, and share the video with your friends, my dear. Okay, so thanks for watching. Thank you.